Mr. Jefferson gave you, did Maggie. Why, it all makes sense now. And to think I nearly, well, wild horses couldn't get me out of here now. Maggie, dear, if I were you, I'd hang on to that bracelet. It'll be something to remember him by.
All right, Mr. Whiteside, almost time. Look her up, start cutting. Here's your time, Mr. Whiteside.
How much time?
A couple of minutes. A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, how are you coming in, New York? Barry had a little lamb, Barry had a little lamb.
Here comes Jefferson's special.
Oh,
have we time?
Oh, I'm sure we have time, Mr. Jefferson. Turns out I'm not leaving after all. My plans have changed.
Really? Well, that's good.
And I've heard you've written a simply marvelous play, Mr. Jefferson. I want you to read it to me tonight, will you? We'll go back to the mansion house after dinner, and you'll read me your play.
Why, if you say so, I'd be delighted. Maggie, did you hear that? Selma, you did this. You arranged the whole thing. Well, it's the best Christmas present you could have given me. Maggie? Maggie!
30 seconds. Waiting.
Mr. Whiteside!
Quiet, please!
My son has run off on a freighter, and my daughter is marrying an anarchist!
Quiet!
They say you told them to do it!
My fortune! My poor Richard! This is the most awful!
Quiet! Quiet, please! We're going on the air!
Oh, I see you're still busy.
Don't tell me to be quiet!
Quiet! For God's sake, quiet! Get out of the way! All right, singers. Right up here. Down with this mic. Okay, New York. Everybody, crew of most friends of Sheridan Whiteside.
This is Whiteside speaking. At this joyous season of the year, when my own heart is overflowing with peace and kindness, I think it fitting once again to tell the story of that still and lustrous night, now up to 2,000 years ago.
A penguin bit me!
When once the star of Bethlehem was glimpsed in a wondrous sky,